Hello everyone, today let's replace the display casing of an HP 15 series laptop. As you can see, this display here, it is totally broken. Show it here, you can see, it has come out, totally come out in this way. Even the antenna cable is broken, Wi-Fi antenna cable is broken as well. We'll check and replace it, and also we can see here that previously they have tried to repair this by applying some adhesive. Maybe this is epoxy adhesive, but it has not stayed long. So now we'll replace the whole front bezel as well as casing of the display. For that, first we will take out the display so that it won't get damaged while doing it. Remember that these screws are smaller one. Four screws need to be removed. It's a bit difficult to remove. And before doing anything, I would advise that removing the battery is the important thing here. Just remove the battery first. Without removing the battery, do not remove the display casing of display connector. We should remove this very carefully because it may break the display. We have applied the epoxy by keeping the display inserted here. Actually, we should remove the display before doing any adhesive work. Can't force it. If you force it, it will break. As the display screen is of glass, we need to be very careful. And it's epoxy adhesive, we can't melt it also by heating. from here now. Only little bit this part is remaining. See here the way they have sticked the epoxy glue. They have poured the epoxy glue, I think so. Okay, we came through the display, remove the display. Just gently remove the connector here. Keep your display safely aside. We'll remove the side issue later. I'll show it to you. Keep the display aside. No need to remove this. Just take out the screws, whichever screws are remaining, because we need the screws to fix to the other panel. New casing. This is the webcam. This is the antenna cable. Here you see. Just go through how it is fixed, how it is dressed up. We have removed the casing. Now we need to take out this is the old bezel, front bezel. This bezel is not broken, you can keep it safely so that if your new bezel breaks anytime, you can use this one. So now we need to remove the hinges. We should take out the hinges as it is broken here, and we need to fix the new hinges. New hinges, we will fix these new hinges now. For that we need to take out all the screws. Remove the epoxy glue consumed over time. These are the 2 foot. These are the keyboard. Here you can see the keyboard mark. If the hinges weren't broken, there was no need to open the cabinet. That is, there was no need to remove this part. only the front bezel we have removed, but as it is broken, we have to remove this. Four screws. Screws under the DVD drive. We need to remove them. Here you see the screws. Remove the screw under the DVD. One more screw is there. Just check thoroughly, I removed all the screws. Before continuing with the this replacement, we will solder this Wi-Fi cable here. Or else we will not get Wi-Fi signal. Don't pull out sleeve very long side, just take a bit. Separate it in this way. You can see this is the core, this is the grounding. So for fixing it, I usually use, after soldering, I insulated with heatsink tubes. If you don't have heatsink tubes, you can wrap it with insulation tape. This is the heatsink tube, the core, and one more a bit lengthier one. After soldering it, just insulate the core. If you have hair dryer, you can use that, or else you can, if you don't have heatsink tube, you can wrap it with a insulation tape. If the grounding wire is not enough lengthy, then you can use one more thin wire to connect it. As it's done now, we will remove the hinges. Remove both the hinges. Try to remove the adhesive which is stick to the cables here. If possible, remove them or else leave it. See that you will not damage any cables. this adhesive is also not that hard. I think he has used less hardener and more epoxy. That is the reason. That is less hardener and more resin he has used. That is the reason it has not become hard. Keep the motherboard casing aside. Now take your new panel which you have bought. This is the new panel. And this is the display. Now we need to clean this part here. So before fixing it, we will clean it. Then remove the epoxy adhesive gently without damaging the screen. Be careful with your fingers. If the blade slips, you will get a cut. This is the thing happens. Clean as much as possible because it will become hindrance in fixing the new cabinet. We have cleaned the display to the maximum point. Place your new bezel here and just take out the cables. Fix the cables or dress the cables as I'm showing it here. Now here you can see there is a notch and a groove on this camera. It should fix exactly there. Here in this way, just press it. Hold dressing the cable in this way as I am showing here. Okay. This is the antenna. cable goes under the antenna. Touch the cable as shown. Okay. Dress it in a proper way into the grooves provided, or else it will not allow to fix the bezel, front bezel, in a proper way. The front bezel won't fit properly if you do not dress the cables correctly. Remove these dots here, or else screws won't fit properly. I'll show you how to dress this. This particular cable here. Because for many it is very difficult. This cable should come in this way. Here. This antenna cable should come from the bottom of the screw head of the mounting. As we have soldered it, it has become a little bit thicker, so trying to insert it gently, don't damage it again. Again, if you damage and if you resolve it again, this wire cable length will be very short. This way, this is the way you have dressed it. Take the new hinges. You are able to see in this way. The antenna cable should come below and the webcam cable should go in this screw here, and along with that the display cable here in this way. You can insert it into the lock here provided. Before fixing it, see that the new hinges which you have purchased is same. It should be same. This one should be same, and this mounting also should be same. So here, try to take out the screws. this link is stuck, this screw is stuck, use a nose plier to remove it. So as this hinges is the same, it matches, fix it. On all those three screws. Remove these dots from other places as well. Well, the screw heads are also filled with the epoxy. The frame is ready and we'll fix the display now. Click the new display. We'll clean it before fixing. Take the glass cleaner. See that the glass cleaner does not enter the PCB here or the borders. It should be in the middle itself. Don't spray it other places. Because glass cleaners, usually some glass cleaners have acidic property in them and they will damage the glue which holds the chip connected to the glass, that is display glass. Fix the screen to the frame we have prepared. First of all, we need to connect the connector here. Hope you are able to see. Connect it in a proper way. See that it is locked properly. Hold the PCB from the bottom and insert it. On these screws. The screw is also filled with epoxy, that is the reason it is a little bit slipping. Fix it in this way. Now before covering it with bezel, we will check it whether it's working. There is no problem with the display. For checking the display, just disconnect the hard disk first, otherwise again you will have to wait for the Windows to boot and then we need to shut it down. So disconnecting is a better idea. First and second pin need to be shorted. As you can see, the display is working fine, so we will pack it now. Shut it down. These first and second pin are the switch. Okay. If you can't make it out, don't short the other two pins connectors. If you can't make it out, connect the top casing with the power switch and then you can try it. So now as the display is working, we'll cover the bezel, front bezel. This is your new bezel. And with the old bezel, just remember to take out this magnet here. This magnet actually, it is used or it works as activator for the activator for your sleep mode switch. That is, when you close the lid, display lid, when you close the display lid, your laptop will go into sleep. So to activate that mode, we need this magnet here. This magnet activates a switch or a relay in the form of transistor, the package of a transistor on the motherboard or the power switch connector. Here you can see, just go on, insert it in this way here. So this is the easy method I am trying to show you. Go on pressing it. Here there will be little bit difficulty because the display has become a little bit thick there due to over epoxy which they have applied in the previous effort. Okay, it's fixed. So now your new panel is ready. We'll fix it now onto the panel, onto the main casing, that is the motherboard casing. Insert your hard disk back. Just dust off the dust here, clean it off with a brush or a anti-static cloth if you have. Okay. Check your new screen. Check if the hinges are too tight. Okay, if the hinges are too tight, you just loosen the nut here, this one on the hinges we have installed. Loosen it a bit, a thread, just a pitch, a thread, loosen it so that it will become a little bit free, and later on again it will become correct. If it is falling, for example, if you are closing it and it is falling on the board itself, later on, as you go on using it, it will be fast and tightened. Okay. Now connect the screws. This connect the display connector, passing it through the grooves provided. this is the display here, and as you can see the Wi-Fi cable is little bit short now because we have to cut it and join it. Take your top cover or touchpad casing, touchpad cover. With this also, before fastening the screws, check for the display working of display. This is the power switch connector here. This is for the touchpad. We'll check for working now. Screwing on. Display is okay. Now the display is working, touchpad is working, so we'll shut it down and pack it. We'll fasten the, all the screws and we're done to go. Okay. Fasten these four screws here. These are of 5mm length. Insert the keyboard. Fasten the screws under the DVD writer. Insert the DVD writer. Go on fastening all the screws. There will be two screws of a bit lengthy, so we need to fasten them here. After fixing the we have them here. Just fasten the keyboard screws here. Keyboard screws also will be a little bit lengthier compared to other screws. Fasten all the screws and we are done. this foot needs to be inserted in this way. We should here in this way, take the screw out here in this way and press it down. Fasten this screw. Okay. Insert your battery and we are done. Hope this video was helpful and was useful for you, and this video has helped you to change your old broken display panel into your new display panel. Kindly hit the like icon, share the video and subscribe to the channel if you have not yet subscribed. Thank you for watching, everyone. Have a good time.